Welcome again everyone. So today we're gonna see our project on restaurant management system in assembly language. Okay, it has took me a long time to do this. It is quite difficult to do everything and execute everything together. It's sometimes so difficult. So now let's see the code, and there's a thousand lines of code here, so don't worry about it. So as we did in our previous videos, just implementation of those concepts here. Once you go through them, you'll be able to understand it. And so let's emulate this and see what we have done here. So if we just emulate, then I have just used some jump instructions here and set template logics, and that's all this we have learned in previous videos. So it's gonna take some time because there's thousands of line of code here, so just wait a bit. Okay, it's ready. Okay now we're gonna run this program. Okay, run this. It's in showing menus what you wanna select. So firstly, I'm gonna select breakfast. So is some options for us what we gonna eat. So you can eat some tandoori roti. Just click one here. So how many roti do you want? I need 5. So the total price would be 50. 5 multiplied by 10 is 50. So here showing another option. If you want to go back to the menu and order it again, or when I just finish things off or exit, just I want to finish things off here. So I'm gonna press okay, let's reload this again. Reload it again. So now run it. So you have already seen how we can do breakfast, and let's press 2 for have some lunch. So showing us some delicious items. So I'm gonna press kachi biryani, which is the famous in the world. So I'm gonna need 2. I'm showing the fries. 2 kachi biryani here, each is 90 taka. So okay, it's showing that you're gonna need 80 taka for 2 kachi biryani. So I'm gonna go back to the menu again. So I'm gonna press 1 and it will take us to the main menu. So now it's time for dinner. So let's see what we have. So what we gonna eat is mutton. Okay, we're gonna have some mutton. Alright, so press 2. Then you have to enter the quantity. So I need 3 for my 3 friends. Alright. The price, total price for 3 chicken tuna khichdi is 240 taka. Yeah, because each is 80 taka. So now I'm gonna go back to the menu again. Sorry, man. Okay, reload again. Run again. Okay, so we have already seen breakfast, lunch, dinner. So now I'm gonna see some snacks. Let's see what we have got here. So we have singara samucha. So I'm gonna press 3 singara. I need 6 of them. So the price would be 30 taka. And go back to the menu again, and this time I'm gonna have some drinks. Now firstly, we're gonna have some sweet meat, so I'm a big fan of it. So let's see what we have. We have faluda, pudding, fini, curd. So I'm gonna have some faluda. So I need 2, and the price for 2 faluda is 100 taka. So I'm gonna go back to the main menu again. And now finally we're having some drinks. So we have some soft drinks, lassi, it's very famous in subcontinent, and biryani, lavang, coffee, tea. So I'm gonna have some biryani with kachi. So I gonna need two biryani, and the price for two biryani is 18 taka, each is 9 taka. Okay, so if you wanna exit, then press 2 and exit the program. Okay, so in this little project, we have just shown how we can select a restaurant management project where you can select your menu and calculate. It will calculate the total, select your menu, which item you want, and the quantity, how much you want, and it will give you, it will provide you the total price that you'll have to pay for them. And it's pretty simple, but it's quite difficult to do it in a simple language. So this is the project what I have made for my course project, as my course project. So I have used just some logical things, just jumps instructions. I haven't used push pop operations, just jump instructions. I use just jump instruction to complete this project, and I encourage you to just follow this project and make it your own project on this basis. And I literally don't want you to copy this project, because I just want you to just have a look at this project and look at this code and just take some ideas what you can do as project. So when I was searching for project, it was quite difficult to find out any ideas about assembly language project in very simple way. So this is a good thing for you. I encourage you to just take the concept from here and do it your own, or I'll provide the link. I'll provide a link where you can find this code, and I'll encourage you to follow this, and you can also build on from here. You can do your project, you can add some new features with it, with this, and do it to make it your own project. So I mean, you're not anything, this is the end of my video series on assembly language programming. I hope you have enjoyed it, and it was a great journey with you all, guys. And thank you. Goodbye from here. Okay, thank you. Bye.